Good morning, children. Welcome to Gyanjyoti online classes. Class 9 and 10 English grammar. Chapter 3. Lesson active emphasis wise continuation of rest of it. Yesterday we discussed present simple, past simple and future simple. And today we shall discuss about present continuous, past continuous. Because future continuous tense have no basic form. It's okay. Let's see. We have to know this present continuous and past continuous rules. Active voice is about closing form or informal verb. Just like I am going. Yeah, I am going informal. Past continuous tense was were plus informal verb. Yeah, this is active form. Yes, I was going. I was studying yesterday. Yesterday I was teaching you. I can say passive form is a verb, okay, that comes being, extra being plus past participle. Always passive form takes past participle. Yeah, main verb always carried on by past participle. You have to know past tense was were plus being plus past participle of the verb. It's clear. So now let's see one of the examples. You are defending his conduct. Yeah? You are defending his conduct. Negative, you are not defending his conduct. Yeah? Are you defending his conduct? Aren't you defending his conduct? You can say. So in a passive form, his conduct will be in the front. Is being defended by you. Yeah? Negative, his conduct is not being defended by you. Including each his conduct being defended by you, or is it each conduct being defended by you? In this way, we can make four types: affirmative, negative, interrogative sentences. You can make in present tense. In the same way, past continuous also just like that. You were just simple, you know, that past tense were, present tense are. These conduct, conduct is similar, that's why verb similar form is, and you can see similar form of was. Let's see. You were defending his conduct. His conduct was being defending past participle. Yeah, was being so defended by you. It's clear. So student, just like you can make negative, affirmative, interrogative. Let's see. You were defended by his conduct, you were not defending his conduct. Were you defending his conduct? Weren't you defending his conduct? These four forms, impressive, his conduct was being defended by you, his conduct wasn't being defended by you, was his conduct being defended by you, wasn't his conduct being defended by you. In this way, we can make the continuous forms of present and past tense from active voice to passive voice with any example. If the one example I discussed, any example you can bring in same pattern, same way it will go on. It's not so hard, just you need to know these forms, whatever it is mentioned. And it is very easy to understand. Yes, student, did you understand?
Okay.
Yes, student. See this sentence: present perfect, past perfect, and future perfect. Let's discuss. And in active voice has had plus past participle, and past perfect had plus past participle form of verb. And future shall be plus had plus past participle form of verb. Okay, so how to create? Let's see. In passive, something had plus been, extra been plus past participle. And here had, just change had. Has had, been plus past participle. Yeah, let's discuss. A robot has naked perfect tense, okay? But here, these pullovers. Plural, that's why have been initiated by a robot. Okay? In past tense, just had. Here we use only head, okay? The robot head needed these pullover sadly needed by robot. This must only change. Present perfect and the past perfect, no differences. Okay, in negative, a robot has not needed these pullovers. Has a robot needed these pullovers? Hasn't a robot needed these pullovers? In basic form, these pullovers have been needed by a robot. These pullovers have not been needed by a robot. Have these pullovers been needed by a robot? Haven't these pullovers been needed by a robot? In this way, my sentence. And here, a robot had needed these pullovers. A robot had not needed these pullovers. In this way, you can know. So these pullovers have been needed by a robot. These pullovers had not needed by a robot. Had these pullovers been needed by a robot? Hadn't these pullovers been needed by a robot? In interrogative sentence. In future also, a robot will have needed these pullovers. Negative noun. Interrogative will a robot have needed these pullovers? In this way, the next sentence. Passive forms. These pullovers will have been needed by a robot. These pullovers will not have been needed by a robot. Will these pullovers have been needed by a robot or will? Won't these pullovers have been needed by a robot in the next sentence with different type and in different examples. We put in this form, we practice more to set up your mind to explain whatever the question is. Okay, student? Yes, student. Let's discuss much about motor injuries, how to make passive active to passive ones, just like motor injuries, sumo can to. May, might, send, sue, then ought to, must, yeah, these are all the modal verbs. And how to make active to passive? There are many examples. I discuss one example. You can do according to that. We should respect every living creature on this earth. Let's see. We should respect every living creature on this earth. Their object part is. Every living creature on this earth is an object part. So every living creature on this earth is applied to the subject part, okay? Then should respect, you should know that actually from the simple part, the example is plus past participle. So is respected, is past participle of respected, is respected. So should is means be form. Instead of writing is, you write be form. Should be respected. Okay? All of we can write. Every living creature on this earth should be respected. Clear? You can make examples in the book we give and you can practice it. It's clear? Now, imperative sentence, just like different types of command order, then. Second point is advice and suggestion. This is third one, what is request. Let's see command orders. Lock all the doors. This is the command order, okay? This is the order. Yeah. Lock all the doors means you have to use let. Let all the doors, okay, into the object part. Lock B lock. You can see from lock only B lock. That is a difference. You have to create an imperative sentence let and it will make basic form. Clear for the student? Number B point, advice and suggestion. Let's see. Don't give false evidence. This is one of the suggestions, okay? So, what to do? False evidence, past object or in subject part, should not be. Don't give me should not be given. Be given. Should comes under advice part. Okay? So you have to use extra should in imperative sentence advice part. Okay? Then come to request. Kindly grant me leave for today. Okay? And this is the passive active form and how to make. And here me is object means I may kindly remain, yet to in request from me, kindly grant is be granted, leave for today. Okay, I of subject, object being subject part, may kindly, it is extra may. In request you can use may or leave for today in subject parts. May kindly be granted. Leave for today. May kindly. May kindly be granted. Means to me. That you have something to me. You understand, student? And I think last part of this chapter, miscellaneous examples means more extra things. Just given there is no time to waste, there is no time to be wasted. Yes, student, can see miscellaneous examples. There is no time to waste. Just this is the active passive, something exception frequency, you can say something odd type. There is no time, there is no time, okay? Here to waste, to be wasted, it is only sad. In this one, this is only some rules. We have to go through the P number part of this chapter. You can even make examples again. Huh? Very simple, you can practice it. And I hope you that whatever I have discussed, if you practice more, you will gain more and you will understand more. And hope you have a good day. Wish you all the best. Study well. Goodbye.